Now, KSBW Weather Plus with Jim VanderZwan.
All right, we'll start you out with a Weather Plus quiz. We got the right one up here. The record level tide for one hurricane was 18 feet, 23 feet, or 30 feet above normal tide line. What do you think? Give that some thought, A, B, or C. Those are your choices. And we'll give Dan and Aaron a chance on it here in just a moment. Meanwhile, back at the ranch, we had a little bit on the Doppler radar. We figured light showers. That's what we got. They moved from northwest to southeast, all part of an upper-level trough, some colder air aloft, and rainfall amounts got 800s in Ben Lomond. Everybody else less than that as of about 4 o'clock. And temperatures, though, ended up where we figured they would be, on the chilly side of November. Yeah, these were your overnight lows a few months ago, 50s. Did hit 60 in Watsonville, didn't last long. Ditto for Marina. We had 59 in Monterey and Carmel and Pacific Grove, 62 in Carmel Valley, 58 in Big Sur. Most lows still in the 40s, a few upper 30s. 60, the most popular number in the salad bowl of the world today, give or take a couple of degrees warmer elsewhere, and 59 in San Jose, Morgan Hill, and Hollister. 58 in Gilroy, the cool side of things. 50s also in the Central Valley up to the mountains. We get a little snow up there at Tahoe. It's going to help a little bit. It's not going to be a big thing. Gone tomorrow, by the way. No big travel issues for Saturday. 70 in Vegas, 74 in Palm Springs. The rest was 50s and 60s, and it is cooling off in other places. Only 39 degrees all day today in Seattle, 45 Boise. A little warmer in the Mile High City. Chicago, not too bad, 51. 64 in Dallas, 10 cooler in Atlanta, GA, and New York, 46. 6 degrees. Most of what the weather is producing as far as wet stuff is out west now with an upper level low, sending showers of rain, snow in the higher elevations, and scattered snow showers out over the plain states. A little bit working into the Sierra Nevada, but most of that, like I say, will be gone by the morning. And not much to go for the rest of the weekend. But the upper-level low is not done. It's going to be sliding down the coast here, while the rest of the map keeps with a high-pressure ridge, maybe a little disturbance out of Canada getting into the upper Midwest. So we're tracking storms out of the Gulf of Alaska. The first low bringing the first layer of cold air. Second one is now diving down, and that's the one that's going to do a little coastal cruising over the weekend. This storm is actually queuing up for Thanksgiving. So here's how it's going to stack up. First one out of the way. This low will track right along the coast, and the models have been varying all week. We're going to go ahead and keep it in here. One of these models does paint some rain and snow. Well, not much snow in the Sierra, but snow in our mountains possible as it's a cold air mass. Then high pressure to start off the week. Then this storm, and you notice with the colors here, much more intense, much more rain. That will likely slide in Wednesday night. So it's going to help kind of moisten up the turkey. Here's the option on one of the other models. Notice this here. Now, Saturday, we're dry. This thing keeps most of the rain just offshore. A few showers early Sunday morning. I'm thinking we'll likely get it at least about as far east as I-5. Rainfall amounts quarter to a third in some of the wetter locations, a lot less for the valley, so it's not going to be a big storm. And most of the deed will be done in the wee hours of the morning on Sunday, so that should help. Only scattered showers thereafter. Temperatures, though, we're going to be on the cool side, as expected. Mostly 50s will have to do it for a while, 40s overnight. But it looks like we might see a few mid to upper 30s, but after all, it's not going to be all that cold. We got dew points up a bit, so no frost. Might see it a little bit colder Monday morning, but not a hard freeze coming up just yet. And mostly 50s as you get around the coast. Likewise, across the bay, not a lot of variation, even a couple of degrees cooler up in the Santa Cruz Mountains. Mostly cloudy. Got a slight chance of a few light showers left over this evening, and then they're gone before midnight. Patchy morning fog and mostly cloudy will make up most of your Saturday. It'll be probably 10, 11 o'clock before the rain starts up again tomorrow night, probably even later than that, farther south from Monterey and Salinas. That'll leave over a few morning showers for the racers, but that's going to be hit and miss stuff, so you may go through a whole race, a half marathon, without even getting wet. And if you do, well, it'll kind of cool you down a bit. For the rest, partly cloudy, certainly by evening time on Sunday, so things quiet down. And then we'll go dry for a couple of days. Like I say, Monday likely the coolest, but not a lot of freezing. By Wednesday night, it looks like we're getting a good rain going there that'll probably spill over through Thursday, even into Thursday night. But, of course, a lot of people snuggle up to a nice warm plate of food, hopefully, and that will be okay. It's part of the season. And this weekend, like I say, just maybe a little bit of rain Sunday morning. The rest of the time it's dry skies, so it's still good for travel. There you go.
Nice.
As long as we get that turkey cooked, we're good.
You got to get it. Yeah. I think you'll be able to do that. So it's nice to cook a turkey, you know, and rain outside kind of puts you in the spirit.
Oh, yeah. No, it's got that whole feeling, yeah.
Yep. All right, Weather Plus quiz. Still leftovers from hurricanes. The record level tied for one hurricane was 18 feet, 23 feet, or 30 feet. What do you think?
I'm going with 23.
18.
Aaron gets it this time. 23. Hurricane Camille. This was in Pass Christian, Louisiana. 20. That's 2.5 stories high. That was one of the bigger surges. Yeah. even bigger.
And remember,
than
they're at sea level most of the time.
That's right.
Or
and
below.
It just kind of took everything out. And,
yeah, 23 feet.
All right.
Yep. That's pretty frightening.
Yeah, no kidding.
Thank you, Jim.
Okay,
Thank you,
guys.
Jim.